And welcome back. We are in Stalwart Village, getting reacquainted with the locals.
Sure.
And seeing what anyone might have to say. Just now entering Hamond's Emporium.
Would I interest you in a new blade?
Don't know about that. I already have an awesome blade. Oh, this Hamond over there. Cheap perfumes line the bottom shelf. You can see your own reflection in these shields. I don't remember this place before. This looks like Stalwart from the road to Deerwood. Mark my words, rededicating Andra's temple to Abaddon was a mistake. I wish folk here would give Darien a chance. Pleasure to see you. The shopkeeper's clothes seem a little nicer, if not terribly warm, compared to what you've seen around Stalwart. His hair is immaculately coiffed, and his rosy cheeks look like they've barely been touched by the mountain winds. Welcome, welcome. I've got arms and armor, all top quality. Or perhaps you'd like to see potions. Always a pleasure to meet respectable company out here, anyway. Show me what you have for sale. Twin Sting. Huh. Oh, it's a soulbound item. Twin Sting is a crossbow with an unusual design. It is built to fire two bolts before requiring a reload. Few are the practical uses of such a weapon that would be worth the trade-off of the extra weight. This item, however, was built to fulfill a very particular need. Yeah. We don't really specialize in crossbows here. Anything unusual? He carries many scars, Helm. +2 athletics, +50 defense while stunned or prone. This armor was forged in honor of the Red Saren monk Rungfar, who came to believe that as long as no enemy could inflict more pain upon him than he could upon himself, he could never truly be subjugated by anyone. Conscripted by his government to quell the uprisings inspired by St. Widwin, Rungfar became a frightful presence on the battlefield. For every injury he sustained at the hands of an enemy, he would inflict one twice as severe, drawing strength from the pain that enabled him to fight through injuries that would have caused anyone else to collapse on the ground. He would charge his enemies covered in blood with tears in his skin from hand to foot, and his foes would shrink at the sight of him, believing, as he did, that it was not in their power to injure such a man. This is like something our monk would do, who we don't use. Near the end of the rebellion, when the rebels had all but overthrown the government, Rungfar found himself in a battle defending against St. Widwin's main forces. Accounts claim that he was the last on his side to remain alive, and he was approached by St. Widwin himself in the end. As the story goes, the living god looked him over and gave a slight bow, permitting him to fall upon his own blade, that he might remain free. The armor bears many artificial scars added by the blacksmith to make its wearer as imposing as the figure that inspired it, though it wears its real scars with equal pride. Well, it's something that anyone could use. +2 athletics. Belt of Bountiful Healing. +25% healing received. Per what? Day? Encounter? What? Ring of the Salonin? Additional spell uses. Two centuries after Telda forged a ring extending her spellcasting powers, a wizard of the Valian Republic sought to improve upon her design. Almert of Salona was never known for particularly original scholarship or spellcraft, but many of his peers accused him of outright plagiarism. It's widely held that this is the reason he never received much credit for this ring, the one truly remarkable achievement of his career. Let's see if anyone can use that helmet. I've seen the stag helm before, I'm pretty sure. Sanguine Plates helm. Despite popular assumption, the Sanguine Plate was not named for its blood-spattered appearance. It was originally owned by a barbarian from Rorotai, and while his combat style did frequently leave the Sanguine Plate in need of a good polishing, it was actually named in reference to the owner's jolly nature. Hey, speaking of which, this lady who's with us, Maneha, whatever, she's gonna need equipment. He was popular around town and in the taverns of the nearby port, where he was quick to buy friends and visitors a drink and glad to hear the news from abroad. However, his seemingly inexhaustible good humor was counterweighted by a hair-trigger temper, and it was said that none who actually saw him in a bad mood lived to tell the tale. Really. So what is this? Stun duration, knockdown duration. All right. If she's got stun or knockdown. I'm gonna get that for her. All right. I don't have Aeloth use the regeneration because he doesn't regenerate fast enough. He doesn't have enough points to last enough to, you know, for the regeneration to work and do its magic. I didn't take her stuff. Devil of Carrick. I guess when I'm done with the town, I'll head back to Cad Nua and do that. I still want more potions. All right, let's check her out. Character sheet, okay. 14th level barbarian, coastal Amawa. Right, barbarian. Like, what's his name? Our other Amawa that we haven't had in the party for quite some time. Trying to see if she has a knockdown ability. I guess it would be listed here if she did. doesn't have to level up.
I'm here.
Barbaric Yell. Savage Defiance. Heart of Fury. Let's get her that other helm. Then again, she's not going to get knocked down that very often, is she? Let's just see what might be good for her. So does she have proficiency? This is what I forget. Like, what does she have now? She doesn't have anything. She has Maneha's armor. Reflects her extensive travels and experiences on the roads and waves of Eora. It incorporates brass baubles, the teeth of ferocious creatures, and myriad small bits of fashion Maneha took a fancy to on her adventures. So she's got light armor. Oh, it gives her plus 25 healing. So I think we're going to keep the armor. But she needs boots, a helm, a couple rings, perhaps, gloves, and a belt. Battle axe, sword, morning star, and crossbow. Well, she has, okay, a fine battle axe and a fine sword. She's dual wielding right out the gate. Fine morning star. Does she have any kind of proficiency in any of this stuff? Right. Both of those. All right. Let's find some goods for her. Let's worry about armor first. Plus 3 resolve. When Gref Admeth Hadrit passed a 10-year treaties on the anniversary of the War of Black Trees, he outlawed the looting of Ingwithin ruins. While this was a popular move against the among the Glanfathans, as well as the frontier villagers, who frequently found themselves the subject of the tribe's vengeance, it was an unwelcome change for the traders and adventurers who had made their living selling Ingwithin artifacts. Quite a few vendors, however, took to commissioning and selling replicas. Many fakes were so skillfully made that even scholars had difficulty deciphering between them, and ciphers were sometimes hired to attest to the authenticity of high-value objects. Argus Adra, Adra Armor, actually was taken from the ruins near the court of Bowing Ashes, but it so closely resembled two known fakes that it famously passed through Defiance Bay and Sens and the Salona before an animancer in Barda recognized its authenticity. It grants plus 3 resolve, which helps with concentration and will and deflection defenses. Can be useful for mental intimidation, leadership, and convincing performances. She does sing. I wonder if it will help with her singing. Not sure. Now, she's not stunned or prone, right? She has a defense against that, so it's not going to happen often. Plus 20 defense, so I'm not sure. Getting that helm is really... would be advantageous there. It wouldn't stop moving. Okay. I don't know why it's doing that. Does it do it here too? Notice there's nothing to scroll. Well, that's a problem. We can't really go shopping if crap like that happens. These identical Abaddon figurines are all of exceptionally poor quality. I don't want that. I'm not sure if that's a problem with the game or a problem with my mouse. Yeah, we're gonna have to put this off. I'll have to figure this crap out, because I can't. That's annoying. Let's go check out the rest of the...
Sure.
Shut up. Let's go check out the rest of the village and come back here. Camping supplies are already full. Let's go in, whose house is this? Tana's house. Kind of confrontation with her. Can't remember now. She might be dead, I'm not sure. She was possessed by something or someone. These teeth have been sanded smooth in preparation for carving. Yeah, there's nothing going on in here. Okay, that's the Grave's Rest. I'm not sure what this building is. Things are better under Renengild. Teodor. Afraid I don't have any more bounties. Well met. Well met. Wayfald.
Hey there. Let me know if you need anything. Sure, ask away. Not sure what I can tell you, though. I haven't been here half as long as most.
Well, I've been through this before, but just to remind myself and you guys, and whoever's tuned in, show you guys for the first time, what can you tell me about Stalwart?
Truth is, I couldn't care less about the town, or the mines. But I like the people. Hardy bunch, living up here in the cold. Shame most of them have packed up. Figure they deserve better. And, well, you've given them a chance at that. So, you know, thanks for what that's worth.
My pleasure. Who are you?
Me? Well, I used to build houses. These days I do this and that. Get work at the fishery sometimes, mending nets. Right now I'm helping with the stockades. The ogres keep us busy. I'm from Ina's Rest, originally. Not so far from your Cadnua, actually. A little ways east. Nice lake nearby. A little like the one here. The weather's a little different up here, though, right? Never pictured myself living up in the mountains, but here I am.
Rayfall chuckles. Although he must have done it so silently we couldn't even hear him.
Right. Anything else, then?
I don't want to read his soul again. Whose house is this? Renengild. Oh, right, the former mayor. Yeah, we did some kind of quest for that guy. I forget exactly what. Hail, Renengild. Messenger from Defiance Bay has arrived at Cadnua. Well, he's gonna have to wait. Judging from the large hole behind the gills, it can be safely assumed this trophy fish was shot with a pistol and not caught with a hook or net. If it isn't the hero of the White Forge. Renengild nods in greeting. She looks more relaxed than you've ever seen her, because she's no longer mayor, I guess. You come back to check on your handiwork? Or are you just here to wish me a happy retirement? Oh. Didn't we complete this quest? I don't want to give her in. Why did you retire? She stretches. I've had enough of politics and town quarrels for this lifetime. So when Tarfos told me he was tired of the mines, I figured that he was ready to get his hands dirty. She smiles. Almost feel sorry for the guy. Yeah, I'm not going to give her in. In fact, she might be at the Gref's Rest. However you say that. I'm not completely sure she might have moved on from there. Told you the White Forge was in there. Now you owe me... Yeah, I... Shh, look. That's the woman who found it. That's right. Yeah, I'm really foggy on a lot of the quests and minor stuff that we did in White Forge Part 1. Ever thought of settling down here? Kern looks upset, yes. I haven't seen Kern yet. Only a matter of time before the locals start blaming us for the cold. People here are so superstitious. One heavy snow and they think the gods are angry. Alright, let's check in on the Gref's Rest. The sea beheld her love. And Bard. Shining bright from on high. I'm not hanging around for the song. Don't see many Valians since Galvino left town. I saw a light coming from Durgan's battery a while ago. Thought it was the ale. He's injured? What's he doing? Staying warm yourself, friend. Why is he injured? Barely injured. He hurt himself with the flames there? So she took a piece into her heart. Yeah, shut up. Good work with those ogres. Theodas, let's have a drink together. Somebody else is going to drink with me. That didn't happen, did it? Never had much of a knack for knife throwing myself. I don't want to knife throw with these guys, but I do want to see what else they might have to say. Hey, you're back. Thought you were done with this place. Berthwin said we certainly thought we were. Turns out New Hamar's a bit of a piss heap. Well, that and Stalwart turned out to be not so bad after a while. You know, army scuffling over the battery aside. Still playing games? You get to enjoying the simple things up here. Not that the practice has done them any good. I don't want to play Orland's head. I think they answer as one, yeah. Oh, Katie. Are we supposed to talk to Katie?
Hello, ma'am. Anything I can do for you?
Guess not. Okay. Someone mentioned Katie. In passing. Light from Durgan's battery. How's the cook doing? Move along. No pilfering from the ovens. Yeah, but I'm hungry. This large piece of stone is adorned with an engraving of a hammer and chisel, though the writing beneath is too worn away to be read. Here's hoping the White Forge brings us some proper business. He looks drunk. Here's to, hick, surviving another day in this frozen pit. Nesta. We were supposed to talk to Nesta, weren't we? Ugh. I thought I ordered ale. She might have brought me the dishwater by accident. Or maybe on purpose. You can never tell. Tarfos sent me. I'm here to negotiate the trade treaty on Starwart's behalf. Finally, I was beginning to wonder if Tarfos had forgotten about me entirely. My first stop is Starwart's fishery. My clients are concerned it's a liability to Starwart's prosperity. I'll meet you outside its front door. Well, sheesh. I gotta run around town anyway. Nesta wants to meet me outside the fishery in Stalwart Village. She said something about the fishery's operation being a liability to Stalwart's prosperity. Oh, great. Stay and warm yourself, my friend. I have to go to the fishery.
Back to warm your hand, Jay. What can I do for you? Nothing like a pint to take the chill off.
Any more healing items? Potions? The stuff's working here. Maybe we should buy something for our friend. Potions of major endurance, yes please. Seems to be okay now. I don't know why it was doing that. He's got enough hoods. Talisman of the Unconquerable. Intellect. I'm sure that helpful that would be. Fulvano's Gloves. Dexterity and Reflex. I might have something that she could use. Coil of Resourcefulness. This is a trap. Weapon change recovery. And plus one dex. There's not a lot of specialty things here. Which is exceptional. I was supposed to buy it. I think this might be all stuff I sold to him. I mean, how many clubs does someone need? Two more. Our mage gets injured quickly. Thank you. Alright. We might have enough potions now.
Please, someone has to do something.
Piss off, Kern. I got enough problems.
Oh, it's that Kern. Hardly anyone coming up the roads these days. You're the first new face in weeks. Alright, Kern, what's up? Decades I've lived here. We've worked and drunk together, and not a one of them will lift a finger. This dwarf's face is damp and blotchy. His outburst seems to take something out of him. He sags, his lined features showing his exhaustion. I'm sorry. I've no heart for conversation. I'm sure someone in here will drink to your health. What happened? I've done something terrible, and I'm not sure I can fix things. This neighbor of mine, Hattie, we've never gotten on at the best of times. With this land dispute, losing half my property, things have gotten out of hand. Oh my god, this second one. Go on. I was drowning my sorrows here in the inn. There was a stranger, Sevestin, obviously from out of town. We got to talking. He's all smiles. Says he's a paladin. That he'll sort Hattie out for me, get my land back if I give him the week's wages. I didn't know he was a bleak walker. A madman. I was half drunk. Thought Sevestin meant he'd speak on my behalf. Put a scare into Hattie. Not kill him. I tried to call him off once I realized. He laughed. Said that doesn't happen. Please, you've got to help me. Nobody else here is willing to take him on. Even for the coin I'm offering.
If I ask number 7, that means I'm not listening to what he's saying. I have some questions. I'll tell you anything if it'll help. What do you want to know? It sounds familiar, but what's a bleak walker? I asked around. Far as I understand, their order thinks brutality is the best way to ensure peace. They don't negotiate and they don't give quarter. Once they've been ordered to clear someplace out, they don't stop until they're done, and they don't change their minds. Pellegrino says, that's more like a force of nature than a paladin order. It seems pointless to me to devote one's life to something so destructive, no matter how they rationalize what they do. I can't do her accent, guy, sorry. They just have to turn up. Half the time, they get paid to stand there and be a threat. I don't understand why Sylvester is doing this. Did Sylvester not tell you he was a bleak walker? Not at first. Not until it was too late, I guess. I'd had a few drinks, but I think I'd remember if he'd announced it. Seems like a petty contract for a paladin. I never even knew there was a contract. How can that be right? Where's Sylvester now? He must be headed out to Hattie's by now. He stuck around there for a few days, after we talked, to gloat, I think, or to wait for someone. But he's left. That's all the questions I had. Kern nods, regarding you anxiously. What do you want me to do? Stop that maniac. And Hattie, make sure he's safe. His family, too. I'll make sure Hattie and his family are safe. Thank you. You're a good woman, Theodess. I try. Hattie lives out east, in Whitestone Hollow. Please hurry. Oh, she's not here in town? I'm not rushing out there right now. Angry and more than a little drunk, a stalwart villager by the name of Kern managed to inadvertently hire a bleak walker paladin to resolve a long-standing feud. The matter has now escalated beyond his control. Traveled to Hattie's house. I met a dwarf named Kern in the Gref's Rest. He begged me to find and stop Sylvester, a bleak walker paladin, before he can harm Hattie and his family. Hattie's house can be found to the east of Stalwart in Whitestone Hollow, close to a trade road. Trade road. Alright. Anything else here? I know there's some rooms back here before we finish up. Place wouldn't be the same without Katie. Good on you for saving her. Alright, she's the one over there. Careful if you're new. The drinks in here aren't watered down. Well, that's a good thing. This means it's been empty. By me, probably. Oh, Winna. I can't see her among all of us. Okay.
Something I can do for you? Halfrick's got me straightening the rooms, but I'll help you if I can.
We have no option, so farewell. This is all stealing, and she'll probably see us. We had a guy in here that we helped at one point. And he's gone, because we helped him. Ah, ha, ha. Let's get the hell out of here, ha, ha, ha. Okay. Gotta call in an episode. Taking longer than I thought to, get reacquainted with the villagers and such, and we have a couple quests to do. We're supposed to meet this lady down by the fishery. We still have to, there's nothing usually here, just look at it. I still have to go to Thirsk's house, if I'm pronouncing that right. Thirsk? And back to Hamond's Emporium and hope we can actually successfully buy some armor and weapons for our friend Maneha. Alright, that's her name.
I'm here.
She's here. So thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong.